You want to test your steering hardware with reproducible failures, even in dangerous driving situations? So stay tuned. Today we are at N-Dynamics and we'll show you a steering test rig. This is where a physical steering is run in closed loop with our virtual test drive solution. Corbinian from N-Dynamics will introduce the system to you.
Thank you, Martin. I'm Corbinian Thaler from N-Dynamics. The modular steering test bench we show today is designed to deliver comparable results for those obtained in vehicle testing. Realistic road load data inputs allow the development of new steering systems such as steer-by-wire. Also, evaluating the transition between manual driving and autonomous driving is possible. With our advanced controller and reliable communication protocol, engineers can confidently use the test bench to its fullest potential. The test bench features clear and fully accessible interfaces and communication with the Vector's HIL system using the state-of-the-art deterministic protocol EtherCAT.
Thank you, Corbinian. Apart from that EtherCAT connection to the M-Dynamics controller, our VT system HIL hardware interfaces to the ECU via CAN or FlexRay. The very compact yet powerful real-time processor on the VT6060 board runs the Canoo RESPAS simulation and the Dyna4 virtual vehicle model. The virtual vehicle runs fully synchronized with the Canoo clock on the real-time processor. This includes the vehicle dynamics and the environment simulation. Therefore, we use the Open Drive and Open Scenario standards. On the host PC, you see the Canoo front end for operation of a system and for test automation. On the right hand side, we have Dyna animation visualizing the scene and showing the tire forces as green arrows. Based on the tire forces, Dyna4 accurately calculates the rack force. The forces are then applied as loads on the real steering rack. The angle input to the steering wheel motor are provided by a virtual driver model. With both inputs, the real steering is driven in closed loop with a virtual vehicle and allows for realistic test maneuvers. The system is ready for integration of ADAS functions, such as autonomous lane keeping. The modular hardware of the VT system also makes it easy to interface to a brake ECU test bench. Thus, you can test the integration of steering and braking functions. That's it from here. Thanks, Corbinian, for showing us the test bench.
Sure, Martin, thank you.
Thank you for your attention and see you next time. If you want to see more videos, subscribe to our channel, and if you have any questions, don't hesitate to contact us.